I told you I would leave you in a heartbeat to be an assistant to an assistant general manager if somebody were to call. He's not going to call me. There's a mutual respect, mutual admiration that I have for my former colleague. He's not going to call me. But, you know, maybe I'll text him and wish him good luck just to kind of get on his radar. Great news is that ESPN Monday Night Football analyst and, you know, former pro personnel man, just football man, good man, Louis Riddick. Interviewing today with the Houston Texans, Friday with the Detroit Lions. This according to Ian Rappaport and others. Worked in the Eagles front office, worked in the Washington front office, played for Bill Belichick with the Browns. Universally respected. This is such a no-brainer. Like, if I'm the Texans, you're not leaving Houston without us making an offer you can't refuse. Don't even do the Detroit interview. And if the Texans let the Lions interview Louis Riddick, like, he should have his pick of jobs. And I'm not just saying that because I work with him. I'm not just saying it because I like him. I'm not just saying it because he's a hell of an analyst. He's a good man who clearly knows the game from every level.
He does.
He does. The only thing he hasn't done is coach it. And knows what he doesn't know. And more important, you know what, Michael? More important than knowing football is probably knowing people. Because when I'm hiring a general manager, I need somebody who's, wait for it, a manager of an organization who knows how to put people in position to succeed and get the best out of them. Or as Steve Jobs once said, I'm not going to hire smart and talented people and then tell them what to do. Okay? He's going to implement a culture wherever he goes. He's been around the game. It comes through in his analysis all the time. I just think it'd be such a home run, such a win for either of these franchises to give Louis Riddick what he's earned and what he deserves, same way Mike Mayock did, same way John Lynch, even though John Lynch had nowhere near, he might have been a great player, had nowhere near the front office and the personnel experience that Louis Riddick has. It took John Lynch from the booth and made him the GM in San Francisco, and that's turned out fairly well. So,
and I like this. I like this trend, by the way.
And if he called me, I'm just saying, you might have to find you another brother from another.
Stop.
He called me to kind of do some odds and ends, some odd jobs or whatever. You know, my resume would include all my Madden franchise championships and my NCAA scouting experience.
Okay, that's what it would include. Okay, how about that? How about that? Bring that up in an interview, please. Bring it up. Say, so, hey, like, Mike, what can you do for us?
I was an insider. What? Remember, Louis, I was an insider back in the day. You know, I was Joe Mark in my former life. You know, that's what I don't know why anybody would call me, you know.
You bring up, like, hey, I once drafted a guy in the third round, Julius Rucker, who turned into a Madden legend. Man. Okay, bring up that kind of stuff. And then you'll be right back here. You know, you'll be off for a day.
I'm a scary judge of talent. What can I say? I'm a scary judge of talent, you know?
But I'm with you. And I think the best word to describe Louis Riddick is thorough. He is just thorough in what he does. He is thorough in his football knowledge. He knows it from multiple layers. He is thorough in his analysis. You can hear it during the games. He never gives you the hot take, the obvious take, the cliche. He gives a reason for everything that he describes on the field. I have to say this, I know it's another network, but I like the chemistry that those three have in the booth. Four of those five, because I'll add Lisa Salters on the sideline. I think Brian Griese is doing a really good job there. Steve Levy, Louis Riddick, Perry, they're official. But I think they're really doing a good job because you know what I love? But my favorite analyst, whether I'm talking about a TV analyst or a general manager, my favorite football people are those who realize that the game is there. The game was there before them. The game will be there after them.
Yeah.
They're stewards. They're caretakers. They're just kind of lightly presiding over the activity.
They work like they love it. It comes through in their work. No question.
Not just squeezing the life out of it. I think you're right. I think Louis Riddick would be great. I think he'd probably be better in Detroit than he would in Houston.
Okay.
Because Detroit, I feel like Detroit is more desperate. And I think more willing to listen. I think they're more willing to listen. Yeah, Houston has had some success. They've won some division titles. Yeah. They've actually won some playoff games recently.
Yeah.
Detroit hasn't won a playoff game in, I think it's 1991 or 1993.
It's been a grip. It's been a minute.
Yeah. And so I think they'll let him come in and do what he needs to do, whereas I'm not sure Houston is in that space yet.
Yeah, Houston does seem a little funky, whatever's going down in Houston. I feel you on that.
The Jack Easterby thing, I don't know what's going on there. What's that all about?
Yeah. I mean, like I said, you know, he should have his pick of jobs. And I think if not that this is what it's about, but an organization, if you want to win the press conference, if you want some buzz, if you want a good energy, if you want an infusion of positivity into your brand, hiring him will be universally celebrated. You will not find a reporter, a writer, an analyst, an insider, a fan of any that will say, "Oh man, they hired Louis Riddick." Like his brand, his individual brand is strong based on the work he's done.
Hey, thanks for watching Brother from Another on YouTube. Make sure you hit subscribe before you leave and be sure to watch us 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Time on Peacock. Appreciate you.